If I'm recording a video, I should probably turn my heater off. Hi, welcome back to my channel. This is Miku Marmalade, back with another video. No, it's been a minute since I have a kind of a topical, I'm gonna talk instead of a little short speed art, but I found myself ranting to myself and I thought, this would be a really good video idea. So, this is more of a rant of pain. It's not a, oh my gosh, I've been wronged. It's more of a, it's that pain when you get a cliffhanger. So, I want to say maybe a year and a half, or actually it's been a minute. I think it's 2018. Oh my gosh, has it been that long? I went on Etsy and I found this like mangaka. She's based in Australia, and I had bought a first volume of her manga. It's called Lollipop, and it's by, well, this is called Lollipop. I haven't had any permission to, like, name drop or anybody, so I don't want to be weird like that. And then I'm like, oh my god, I got this book. Like, the front cover looks so cool and stuff. And then I had got it, and then something kind of happened. I couldn't read it right away. And then I realized, like, she had a series, so I'm like, okay, I don't want to read the book yet in case there's a cliffhanger, and that, then, oh my god, that would be painful. And then I saw that she went on vacation, or she didn't have anything in her shop available to purchase volume 2 and whatnot, so I'm like, okay, cool, I will wait to read it. So, this is back in 2018, and for whatever reason, June of 2021, my dumbass decides to read it with, completely forgetting why I didn't read it at all yet. And I got hooked on the line. Like, okay, so this is written and drawn by one person, and I could tell it's a very passion project kind of based thing. Like, it has a very, and not to say in an insulting manner, but it has that, like, amateurish kind of charm to it. Like, you know it's not made by Viz Media or Tokyo Pop, or I think Tokyo Pop went out of business. One of those places went out of business. Like, it's not a big professional, but it's still, it was so charming. And I'm like, oh my god, I need the second volume. I need all the volumes. Oh my goodness. And then I went to a shop and I saw only ships to Australia. And I'm like, no. No. Oh my god. Why? And I understood it, like, as the Etsy shop owner myself, I only shop to the US. So my first thought is, okay, shipping must be exorbitantly expensive. Honestly, when I first bought it, she had really low shipping prices. So I didn't know if she A, either didn't know correct shipping, or B, if she had it subsidized, or somebody had cut her a deal or something. I thought it was very undervalued from when I first bought it. I don't remember how much I paid for shipping. But then I thought, oh my gosh, like, it stinks. Oh my gosh, I want to know what happens. And then I looked at her socials. She has Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook, which I don't have Facebook. I don't have Twitter, and I don't really use Instagram. And I'm, like, a part of me is just like, okay, it's totally within the rights of an artist to just not ship to certain places. Like, I'm not mad at that or anything. Like, I ain't even mad at that policy. It's just when you read something and you get so connected, and I'm like, I just want to support the art. I just want to support it. I just want to support it. Right now, I'm a little bit broke right now, but I guess the only thing I can say is I can maybe send her a message and ask if she's willing to make an exception. Like, I will pay whatever you want. I just, a part of me really wants to have a physical book, or ask her, hey, can I pay for a digital copy? It won't be as good, but I also want to know the story. Like, the story itself, it has, like, kind of a, it goes into, like, gangs and stuff, and, like, a bakering competition. It's a really, really cool concept. Like, I loved the story so freaking much. I'm like, this would be a good anime. Like, I could see this being an anime itself. And then I'm thinking, well, there's a lot more shittier stories out there that has made it into an anime. In another world with my smartphone. And not to say that trash anime is just the worst. Like, I'll be the first one to admit, I like me some trash anime. To me, that was a trash anime. There's a difference between trash anime and unwatchable anime. And for me, trash anime just falls into the camp of, it's not memorable. You watch it, it's like getting the generic brand of Cheetos from the dollar store, like the cheese puffs. Like, it fixes your first, like, it fixes your itch for your cheese craving, but, like, you know, it's edible, but you wouldn't rave home about it. That's what trash anime to me is. But yeah, that is just my little rant, or my pain. Again, and if she says no to both, it is what it is. Won't be the first thing. That won't be the first time I've met an cliffhanger. Cries in, no game, no life.